Well, Phillies Nation, you wanted JT Realmuto? Well, you got him. The Phillies have re-signed JT Realmuto. It is an exciting time here in Phillies Nation. And today we're about to talk about the new contract that our catcher got from the Philadelphia Phillies. And let's get this started. And that is right. Welcome everyone to my channel. It is your boy, El Parcero Philly, the uniter of all things sports and culture here in the beautiful city of Philadelphia. And before we move forward, ladies and gentlemen, please do not forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell button for notifications, as well as sharing this video and this channel to help your favorite Parcero grow here in the beautiful city of Philadelphia. That's right, guys. It has been a long time since we have talked Phillies baseball. Probably since Dave Dombrowski was announced as the president of baseball operations here in Philadelphia. So it's been a while. It's been since December. It's been about a whole month since we talked Phillies baseball. But this saga that was JT Realmuto has finally come to an end, as JT Realmuto has signed a five-year deal worth $115.5 million, making him the most expensive catcher in baseball right now. Well, look, we've been following this saga way before the 2020 season even started. We were wondering whether or not JT would come back. And, you know, for a lot of the season, even after the season ended, it just really looked like it wouldn't happen. We all know the Phillies have lost a lot of money due to what COVID did to the sports world. A lot of teams have lost a lot of money. And, you know, obviously after the season ended, the Phillies ownership, Middleton and whatnot, they all just wanted to come out and cry wolf, saying that we are broke. Like, come on, really? This is baseball. You guys have been pulling money out of your butts for the last two decades. You've got money. But no, so the Phillies make the signing. You know, I don't know how to feel about the signing, because obviously as a fan, you know, we all wanted JT back. You know, we all created the mantra, sign JT, right? But, and he is the best catcher in baseball. Don't get me wrong. He is the best catcher in baseball. You know, he's obviously as a catcher, he is the best, but he has one of the best bats. That's why he's the best catcher in baseball. But I just look at the move and it really doesn't excite me too much as I think about it as a on paper. Because this, now we're bringing, seems like we're bringing back the same team. You're bringing back the same core of a team of players that last 2 years didn't make the playoffs. And I don't know how excited I'm supposed to be when it is what it is. But, you know, Bryce Harper wanted JT back. He emphasized that he needs JT back. JT's an important part of this team. If we are going to make a run, listen, we do have some good leadership in this dugout up top, especially starting with Joe Girardi. Then you got Bryce Harper, JT Realmuto, Aaron Nola, Zach Wheeler, even some veteran guys like Kutch and Reese. So on paper, this doesn't seem like there's going to be much difference here with the Phillies. Obviously now we settled that hole. We finally, after months and months and months of speculation, we have signed JT Realmuto. And it was crazy too. I didn't even mention, like, you know, the Mets were involved, and then the Mets went out and decided to sign the White Sox catcher. That's just really missing my mind. Went by my McCann, I think his name was. But then the Nats kind of stepped in, and then the Braves stepped in last minute. And I think those two were really just brought into it just to kind of, you know, stir up the pot. I think JT's people were trying to get the negotiations going. And then, like, last week we heard the deal was $110 million over 5 years. And then JT and his people finessed and got themselves $5.5 million. JT wanted his best possible deal. He's 30 years old. He doesn't realize, you know, maybe his best baseball. He might have, I think he's got 5 to 6 years left of good baseball. And he wants to get paid for it. He wanted 7 to 10 years. I know he wanted $200 million, but the fact of the matter is, it's just the wrong time right now to demand money. You know, teams have lost a lot of money due to COVID, and I think he got the best possible deal, to be quite honest with you. And for the Phillies, this is the best case scenario. You get your catcher back. You get what Bryce Harper, your star player, wanted all along. And you didn't have to... You broke the bank, but not the way you thought it could have gone. We could have seen 10 years, $213 million, like something like that. But luckily, we were able to get that done. But so now with JT signed up, the catching position is set. We have JT Realmuto back from last season. And Andrew Knapp sure is going to be the backup again. So we're set at catching. Really, now what's the key is the inside of the infield, you know, shortstop mainly. What are we going to do there? We were really highly linked to Anderlton Simmons. It looked like Dombrowski really wanted him. Guy I wouldn't have been mad at. He does have he is injury prone, but he is someone that has a good glove and an okay bat. But obviously he went to the Minnesota Twins. All the good shortstops are really off the board right now. Marcus Semien went to Toronto. Freddie Galvis, which I wasn't too excited about. I love Freddie. Freddie has a good glove, but we needed a little bit more with the bat. So he is going to Baltimore. So really, you know, what do we do now? So obviously, the logical move would be to re-sign Didi Gregorius to bring him back. And he right now is looking for a 2-year, $30 million deal, according to his people. I'm not too enthused by that. Just simply because, like I said, going into this year, you know, we bring back JT, and then let's say you do bring back Didi Gregorius. What makes this team better than last year, or better than even the year before? I want to believe that what we have done with the bullpen is going to help. You can't get any worse than what we did last year with the bullpen. But what makes us different than last year? So if the DD thing does not work, the thought is you put Gene Segura back to shortstop. There are some second basemen out there. You got Colton Wong, Jonathan Villar, and Jonathan Schoop out there. You can just move Segura back to shortstop, and you can sign one of these second basemen. I'll be honest. I don't want to see Segura back, let alone back at shortstop, to be quite frank with you. So he looked better at second base, to be honest. He's not a third baseman. Let's get that out the way. And obviously, Alec Boehm has locked that down, thank God. But no, I think the best case scenario right now is to re-sign Didi Gregorius, as much as I'm not really on board with that. And then you go with Gene Segura back at second base, so you're essentially going to have the same team here again. But like I said, you need to figure out the inside of that infield. You know, whether you do bring back Didi or you sign a second baseman and move Gene. So they're going to have to figure that out. I still think that the job is not done. I still think you need another late late inning arm in that rotation as well. We've signed Archie Bradley. We signed Jose Alvarado, which I think we did talk about as well on my channel. We signed Coonrad. So we got some new arms here in this bullpen, and the Phillies did just sign Ivan Nova as well. The thought is he signed to a minor league deal. Now, Ivan Nova, from my understanding, has been around the league for a while. He played 7 seasons with the Yankees, did play with Joe Girardi while Joe Girardi was the manager of the New York Yankees. He's been bouncing around the Chicago White Sox last year with the Detroit Tigers for a brief stint. He only pitched 19 innings. He had an 8.9 ERA in 19 innings, so that wasn't good. So it looks like he's declining, but they're trying to get a bang for their buck here. If he does actually make the opening day squad, then he will make $1.5 million for the season. But if not, he'll stick to the minor league minimum. These type of deals I don't get excited about, because I feel like these deals just don't work in Philadelphia for whatever reason it may be. And I know Joe Girardi, we should give him some more time, but can Ivan Nova actually give us something? You know, we're talking about the fifth starter here. That's what we're talking about. And I don't know if he can be that fifth starter. So this pitching staff is still not set. There's still a lot of work to be done, but the consensus around Major League Baseball is that the Phillies are going to be last-minute buyers. It's like me on Christmas, during Christmas. God damn it, man. Like, oh my God, these This Phillies team, it's so frustrating, and for the first time in a long time, I've kind of fallen in love with the core that we have here, JT Realmuto, Aaron Nolan, Bryce Harper, and this team is just not good enough. And we have to remember, the rest of the division is getting better. The Braves are going to still be the Braves. They might win the division again. The Nats, I still think they'll be a solid team. I think they are better than us. They've really, since Bryce Harper has left, have really built a complete team. We did them a favor by getting rid of Bryce Harper, and they didn't have to pay him all that money. Go figure. The Marlins are going to continue getting better. They have one of the best young cores in baseball, and they're going to continue getting better. And, of course, the Mets are spending money. And we very well might be in last place unless this lineup hits consistently, which at times last year we were missing. Reese is healthy, playing out of his mind. Gene Segura gets his head out of his ass. If Didi comes back, I'm not too worried. Didi was solid last year. That's the thing. I don't want to, like, you know, come at Didi, because Didi was solid, and there's a reason why he's asking for 2 year, $30 million. But like I said, it's the same team as last year. And last year, we didn't make the playoffs when we should have. And that's the other problem. The expanded playoffs are no more. How are we supposed to make the playoffs now as the fifth or fourth seed, when last year we couldn't even make it as the eighth seed? So I'm not feeling really too confident right now by the Philadelphia Phillies. But hey, it is good news. JT Realmuto is back. That is something to salivate over, but, you know, the job is not done. Of course, guys, as more news comes along, I will continue talking about it. We are getting closer to Philly season. We are getting closer to Union season, our summer teams. So once we get closer, more and more Phillies and Union content will be coming along. It's gonna be like the Flyers and the Sixers. The content's just gonna coincide, and I'll be going crazy again during the summertime. But luckily, again, starting tomorrow, I will be down by the Poconos, relaxing, having a drink, enjoying the nature, and all it brings along. So it should be fun. But guys, big day. JT Realmuto's back. In the comments below, let's continue the conversation. Let me know what your thoughts are on the JT Realmuto signing. JT's back, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for watching. If you watch up to this point, please do not forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell button for notifications, as well as sharing this video and this channel to help your favorite Barcelo grow. And until next time, ladies and gentlemen, I go by the name of Ed Barcelo Philly, and I'm telling you guys, ring that damn bell. Talk to you soon.